So good morning friends, today we'll perform the experiment to observe the effect of nature of applied voltage on breakdown. So in this case we are using three types of voltages: AC voltage, DC voltage of positive polarity, DC voltage of negative polarity. So these three types of voltages we are using. We are keeping all other conditions same. We are performing this experiment at atmospheric pressure and temperature. And for getting the better idea about the effect, we are using non-uniform electric field. That is, we are using point plane electrode geometry. Pointed electrode will be connected to the high voltage source, whereas the flat electrode, that is this type electrode, will be connected to the ground. Now let us come to the experimental setup. So for this experiment we'll require high AC voltage source, high DC voltage source and the rod gap apparatus to perform the experiment. So this is high voltage transformer, 75 kV, 5 kVA, output is 75 kV, RMS value. This we are connecting to the diode. Now presently the diode is connected to give the output DC voltage of positive polarity. So this output of the diode is connected to the capacitor filter. 100 kV diode, 100 kV capacitor filter. The output of this 100 kV capacitor filter is given to this high resistance. In series with this high resistance, a micro emitter is connected in the control panel and that is calibrated in terms of the output voltage. So here we are using series resistance micro emitter method for measuring the high DC voltage. The same DC voltage output we are connecting in this rod gap apparatus. You can see here point plane electrode geometry. Point electrode is connected to the high voltage supply and this flat electrode is connected to the ground. Now this is called as rod gap apparatus. Here we can change the electrode geometry. Presently point plane electrode geometry we are using so that we are creating the non-uniform electric field. Here you can see the distance measuring gauge. Both are movable. We are keeping this fixed. Now at present it is zero adjustment. You can see here it is zero adjustment. Now both are touching each other, both the electrodes are touching each other, means distance between the electrodes is zero. In this experiment we go on changing the distance from 0.5 cm, that is 5 mm, to 5 cm, that is 50 mm, in a step of 0.5 cm, or let us say 5 mm. Now I am adjusting distance to 5 mm. This is 5 mm distance. For accurate measurement, here also we have to match the zero position. You can see the distance between the electrodes. At present, it is 5 mm. So first reading will be with electrode spacing of 5 mm with positive DC voltage. Now I am closing the door of this Faraday cage so that we can start the high voltage setup. So I am starting this high voltage DC test set. Mains on, HT on. Now this meter will indicate the voltage output of the transformer, that is AC, 0 to 75 kV. This meter indicates input voltage to the transformer, 0 to 230 volts, and this meter shows the DC voltage output. Basically, it is micro emitter connected in series with high resistance, and it is calibrated in terms of high voltage. So I am now increasing the voltage. You can see the voltage increase in this voltmeter. Once again I will show HT on. You can see the polarity I have kept at positive because diode is connected with positive polarity. Increase. So voltage was 6 kV, between 6 and 8 kV. Now before touching to any of the part, for basically I have to touch it for distance adjustment, we have to discharge all the test terminals as well as high voltage terminals by using this discharge part. First high voltage terminal. Second. Now I can safely touch this rod cap apparatus. Now I will adjust the distance to 1 cm, then 1.5, then 2, 2.5, and so on. Now we have taken readings from 5 mm up to 4.5 mm. Now finally I am showing the reading and breakdown voltage for 5 cm, that is 50 mm gap. You can see the distance, it is 50 mm. Here spacing, it is 50 mm. You can see the flashover which will be created in between these two electrodes. Now you have seen the arc which was generated between these two electrodes. With positive polarity DC voltage with 50 mm spacing, the voltage reading was 28 kV. Now same experiment will perform with negative DC voltage. So distance is already adjusted to 5 cm or 50 mm. So we start from 50 mm and we'll go on reducing the distance up to 5 mm. Now it is connected in positive polarity. I have to reverse it. Now I have reversed the polarity and I will apply the voltage.
एक बार और
Now for the same gap spacing, you have observed the flashover with DC voltage of negative polarity. The voltage was very high, it was 68 kV, whereas with positive polarity it was just 28 kV. You must have observed the difference between the arc as well as sound when the flashover is with DC positive polarity and DC negative polarity. Now same experiment will perform with AC voltage. For this, first we take the readings by reducing the distance up to 5 mm and then we perform the same experiment with AC voltage. Now we have taken the readings with DC voltage of negative polarity from 50 mm up to 5 mm. Now we are changing the voltage. Now we are using AC voltage. So this is high voltage transformer 75 kV. This is high voltage terminal. This we are directly connecting to this point electrode. This is plate electrode. This is grounded. You can see the distance. It is 50 mm. So for 5 cm, that is 50 mm, we have taken the reading with AC voltage. The reading is 38 kV RMS. Now for comparison, we have to convert this RMS value into peak value. So 38 into root 2, that is approximately 57 kV. So with 5 cm gap, the breakdown voltage or flashover voltage with DC positive polarity was 28 kV, DC negative polarity 68 kV and with AC it is 57 kV. Now we go on reducing the distance between these two electrodes. We change it up to 5 mm and we take the AC breakdown characteristic. Finally, you have to plot the characteristic of breakdown voltage with AC, DC positive polarity, DC negative polarity versus distance between the electrodes. Thank you.